to be with you.
Have you spoken directly to anybody in the senior ranks of the military to see if they share your understanding that President Mubarak must leave office in the very near term?
I haven't talked to any of them, Elliot. I think they know what I am. They know where the other parts of the opposition are. I have no doubt they understand that. I mean, they are part of the Egyptian society, and they understand that there is no, the Egyptian have been, this is a peaceful revolution, and there is no way back. And as JFK once, I think, said that, if you smother a peaceful revolution, you turn it into a violent revolution. So I hope Mubarak just get the message and leave.
The interesting thing today was watching the military that seemed to be there to keep the peace and almost to protect the protesters. Have they changed their role in the last 24 or 48 hours, do you think?
I think so. I think that they have been moving back and forth. At the beginning, a few days ago, they almost encouraged people to go to the street. They said, we fully understand your legitimate demands, similar to what Ben Ali in Tunisia said a few weeks ago, a message that we should have heard from Mubarak. Then the last couple of days, they were conspicuously absent from the street, and you saw the violence that took place. Now they are back in control, and they made sure that the demonstration is peaceful. I think they realize that they do not want to have the wrath of the people, and because they have people always look to the army with a sense of pride, and I believe they want to maintain that.
Well, having seen that change in their role, something that was very clear to those of us watching from a greater distance, of course, it makes me wonder, has Vice President Suleiman, who is, of course, from the military, has he sent a message that he wants the military to distance itself from President Mubarak?
Maybe that, that is the if you put the good side, the good interpretation on it, I hope so. I think there is a gradual, in my view, Elliot, there is a gradual shift, to say that we are not, as the military, side with Mubarak against the Egyptian people. That is obviously a logical choice any army will make. I mean, we are not in any way, Elliot, looking for retribution. We want to go forward. Egypt is in a terrible state economically, socially, politically, and we need to, put the pieces together and move forward. And, Mubarak will not be on our mind any longer.
Can the United States persuade President Mubarak to resign? If President Obama picked up the phone and said to President Mubarak, "You must resign," would that have any impact?
I have been in consultation, with the administration, expressing to them my views on what is going on, expressing to them the frustration of the Egyptian people. I believe they are doing what they can, but of course, they do not want it to appear that Mubarak has been asked, quote unquote, by the U.S. to leave. They would like that to come from the Egyptian people. But I think they are doing their best right now. They have been behind the curve at the beginning, but right now I think they're catching up, and catching up quite fast.
With whom have you been talking in the United States government?
Well, Elliot, I am in contact with Ambassador Scobie here in Cairo. I've been in contact with a member of the administration, but I would leave it at that.
Now, earlier, if I read properly from another interview you gave, you said you were trying to put together a coalition to plan for a new constitution. Can you tell us who else is in that coalition?
Well, I think I've been in contact with primarily with the young people who initiated, this revolution. I've been in contact with many leaders in the civil society. I have been in contact with the leaders of the Muslim Brotherhood. I've been in contact with most of the influential part of the Egyptian society to try to say, hey guys, we need to save our country. We need to go into transition from dictatorship into a democracy. And I think we are united in our demand. Mubarak should leave, a transitional government with the participation of the army to ensure smooth transition, or co-sharing of power, if you like, and then prepare the ground for a democratic constitution and fair and free election. I think we are not the first to do that, Elliot. I mean, we are not inventing the wheel. I mean, look at the whole Latin America, the whole Eastern Europe. So we are clear on our basic demands. We need a new Egypt. We 60 years of dictatorship of an authoritarian system is much more than anyone can bear.
Has anybody in the military agreed to participate in this coalition in drafting a new constitution?
Well, they haven't yet declared themselves, Elliot. That's part of the problem. And I think that the earlier the army declares itself in the side of the people, the earlier they start to have an open dialogue, the better we get ourselves out of this standoff. And I hope whoever can help us to help, you know, to make the army understand that impartiality does not mean neutrality. You know, would help to move things forward, because they are the one right now. They are the most important part of the puzzle right now.
Right. I think everybody seems to agree on that. Have you actually begun to have a sequence of meetings with the other members of this coalition to begin drafting the sequence of events or to draft a new constitution?
Well, I think what we need, Elliot, right now is we would not probably have the time to have a completely new constitution, but I think we have been in agreement right now that we probably have a presidential council of three members, including somebody from the army. We have a government of caretaker government, or as Barack Obama mentioned it, or a government of technocrats, people with new faces, with competence, with integrity, who would then run the country for a year, prepare the ground for the necessary changes in the electoral process to ensure that we will have all what we need for a free and fair election. If we have a new constitution before that, that's well and fine. If not, let us go for a new parliament, new president, and then have the time to have a constituent assembly to have a democratic constitution, and then go on.